There's three Sonics!
And Knuckles. And Knuckles. And Knuckles.
Hey, Rama.
Hey, Knuckles. What's up?
Your subscribers have been asking you to animate me on IBSpan X. Are you sure? Yes. Can you do that, please?
Yeah, sure thing. I can do that. And I have a new pen display, the Canvas of Tingen 3, from you on. I'm going to use this to sketch Knuckles the Echidna on Photoshop, but don't worry, because after the sketch, I'm going to continue animating him on IBSpan X, okay? Let's go.
Let's make a sketch.
Alright, the stand is ready. The tablet is also ready. Let's try it out and make a sketch of Knuckles the Echidna. Alright, I'm already on Photoshop. Let's create a new canvas. Let's add a circle and some guidelines to draw his face. The first thing you want to draw is Knuckles' eyes. His eyes are similar to Sonic, except they're separated like tails. Think of moving Knuckles' eyes. Add an oval iris in there. His eyes are always angry or serious, so make sure to give him eyebrows. Okay, next, the muzzle. It's basically Sonic's muzzle with a longer snout than tails. For the mouth, he's usually serious, but let's give him a smirk so he can have a nice time gliding in the air. Okay, there we go, now he looks nice and chill. So, Knuckles' head isn't a circle like Sonic or square like Tails. His head shape is more like an egg or an alien looking head. I know it's weird, but you'll see why his head is like that. And now, his dreadlocks. Knuckles' dreadlocks are usually down since he's gliding. Let's make them go back, but not like Sonic, of course. His dreadlocks are shaped like bananas. So, draw four bananas on the back of his head, like this. Okay, that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, once the head is done, it's time to draw the body. His body type is similar to Sonic or a lot of other Sonic characters like Shadow, Silver, even Espio. But Knuckles' body is slightly bigger than Sonic. Next, add a slightly thicker noodle to make his arm. Draw the wrist and his hand. His gloves are boxing gloves, by the way. And add two spikes on his knuckles. Make sure you make those spikes huge, okay? Okay, once you're done, do the same thing with the other arm. By the way, you want to send me the Canvas 13 Gen 3 to try it out. And so far, I think it's great. When I'm drawing on this screen, it feels like I'm drawing on paper. And the pen pressure is pretty responsive. It's smooth, feels like butter. Luckily, this pen doesn't need charging because it's battery-free. Unlike my Apple Pencils. And now let's get to the shoes. Let's start with the socks first. Knuckles' shoes are shaped like bricks. When you're drawing Knuckles' shoes, make sure his soles are slightly thicker. And also include a 2x3 Lego plate on top of his yellow straps. After the shoe is finished, duplicate the shoe and move it to the right slightly. Let me merge this down. There you go. For the legs, just like the arms, but make them straight like a stick. And draw the other leg. Alright, once this sketch is done, I'm gonna save and export it to my iPad and open up IBSpan X to continue the process.
Time for outline, coloring, and animate.
Alright, here's the sketch, and the next step is the outline. We're gonna start with his face. Let's draw the eyes, nose, irises, muzzle, and the rest. Okay, that's his face. Let's put this layer in a folder. Let's name it head. By the way, we're not gonna draw Knuckles frame by frame because we're gonna make 8 separate body part folders of Knuckles, so it'd be easier to animate him later. I've done this type of animation before in one of my videos, like Sonic Run IBSpan animation, or how I animate using IBSpan X and Flipperclip. You can go check them out. If you're wondering, what type of animation is this if it's not hand-drawn? This is called rake or puppet animation, also known as training animation. Oh wait, I almost forgot his tail. Make sure you draw that. Alright, the outlines are done. Moving on to coloring. We're gonna use Knuckles color palette from Sonic Dream Team to match with my previous Sonic IBSpan animation videos. Once we're done with the colors, put all of these body part folders in another folder so we can move the model around later. And make sure you put them in order. The rest, I'm gonna add shading and some highlights. You know, it's weird when Knuckles is gliding. He doesn't like Superman or every other superheroes that can fly. Except, he doesn't fly.
Knuckles! You didn't tell me you could fly!
No, I can glide.
You see, Knuckles is a echidna, and real echidnas don't glide like flying squirrels or sugar gliders. So, how does Knuckles glide then? There are a few explanations for this. According to the Sonic Wiki, it claims that he traps the air under his dreadlocks, which echidnas don't have, allowing him to glide. But that doesn't make sense. It might have something to do with the Master Emerald he usually guards on Angel Island or something. In fact, Knuckles has some powers granted to him by the Emerald, as stated in the lyrics of Knuckles' Pumpkin Hill in Sonic Adventure 2. He states that the Great Emerald's power allows me to feel.
The Great Emerald's power allows me to feel.
Alright, this looks good. Now let's duplicate this frame into 3 extra frames. Why? Because we're going to animate him. Knuckles have a bunch of different gliding animation styles like Sonic 3 and Knuckles, Knuckles Chaotix, Sonic Adventure 1 and 2, Sonic Boom, just kidding, Sonic Frontiers, Sonic Movie 3, and many more. I don't really have a favorite, but what's your favorite Knuckles gliding animation style? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, here's a fun fact. Knuckles was created and designed by Takashi Yuda. During the game development of Sonic the Hedgehog 3, the development team wanted to create a new rival character for Sonic. Sega aimed to appeal to the American market with this new character, and multiple designs like this black cat and a mole were pitched for Knuckles. There was even an idea of Knuckles to be a reptilian like a dinosaur due to the popularity of Jurassic Park at the time. Eventually, the dreadlock echidna design got chosen. Originally, it was colored green. But the design team decided to move forward with the color red and focus on strength as its main characteristics, to most likely rival Sonic's speed. And so, Knuckles was born.
Great Claws in case of emergency!
Okay, it's finished. Let's see the animation. Alright, that looks great. Let me copy paste 4 frames over and over again to extend the animation, so I'll be right back.
Six months later.
I'm back, and for the last part, let's make his eyes blink so he can look more natural and alive. Okay, great, we can save the animation now, and here's the final result.
It's unboxing time!
Let's see what's inside this box. Well, okay, first thing we have all the information about color calibration. And next we have the tablet itself, but still inside the plastic. And then we have, wait, what's this? I think it's a tablet stand. Let me get this out. Oh my god, it is! It seems to be a tablet stand user manual. How do I open this? Oh, okay. So if you want to put your tablet in a lower angle, and if you want to put your tablet in a higher angle, you can do this. Okay, next, it has 3 items. This is a drawing glove. I'm not gonna use it in this video because I don't usually draw with drawing gloves. A handkerchief to clean your tablet. A quick start guidebook with multiple languages. Next, we have a pen holder. It looks like a donut. Inside the pen holder, it has 10 extra pen nibs. And in the back, it has a tiny hole to remove your pen nib from the pen. Okay, next we have the pen itself. This is the latest Pentek 4.0 technology. The PW600L pen is equipped with HV200 chip, with 3 side keys, and a dustproof grip. It not only provides a real pen-like experience, but also boosts efficiency. Also, you can put your pen in the pen holder vertically or horizontally. And this is battery-free, no need for charging. Next, we have 3-in-1 cable. I'm pretty sure this connects to the pen tablet. And these connect to PC, laptop, or Mac. And then we have USB Type-A power cable extension. Last but not least, the tablet itself. There you go. Ta-da! Okay, looks like we got pink. This pen display has two different colors. This one is Sakura Pink and the other one is Cosmo Black. This canvas glass adopts anti-glare, optimizes anti-sparkle, and it provides a paper-like texture for real drawing feel, and it is fully laminated. As you can see here, it has two DAO controllers, one more presets, and five press keys with a silent design, and at the top, this is power on and off button. If you look at the material in the back, it's solid, and it has four rubber feet. It has two ports. This one is for 3-in-1 cable, and this one is for USB Type-C. Okay, we finished unboxing this pen display. Let me hook it up to my iMac.
Do not forget to install the Huion driver.
Okay, now with everything unboxed and I have this tablet ready, let me show you how to install the driver.
Okay, the first thing you want to do is type huion.com. Yeah, go to the website, go to products, then canvas. Yeah, click canvas 13 gen 3, then go to download, and there you go. As you can see, there are Windows driver, macOS driver, and Linux driver. I'm gonna download the macOS driver because I'm using an iMac. There you go. Okay, there are two different versions of the macOS drivers. On the top, I'm pretty sure this is the recent one, the latest version, and below is the other version. If you're using an old iMac, the latest version might not work for you, so you can use the older version. I'm gonna use the older version because I'm using an old iMac. Click download. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, once you install the driver, here's the Canvas 13 Gen 3. You can open the digital pen here. As you can see, you can customize the three shortcut buttons on the pen and also the crusher settings. Yeah, you can test it out like this. Let's try this one. Oh, nice. All right. Yeah, you can go for thicker or thinner like this. You can even customize the two drag controllers on the top and the bottom. Yeah, you can just customize the five shortcuts here. Whatever suits you.
And this is honest review. In my opinion of Huion Canvas 13 Gen 3, I think I have no problems with drawing on this tablet at all, especially when it feels like paper, and I think that's pretty cool. The good things about this tablet, it can be used for left-handed artists. And the colors on the screen look fine and accurate, which is nice. Thank you, Huion, for sending me this tablet. I really like it. For the price and other details, you can check the link in the description below. For my digital artist friends who are looking for something that can improve your art skills, then this pen display is for you. If you find this tutorial helpful, feel free to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, keep creating, and have fun.